Hello, welcome to this lecture on Introduction to Probability Theory, presented by Sivanesan G, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Government College of Engineering, Salem. On completion of this chapter, the students are expected to understand the basics of probability theory and random experiments and simple events. We shall start with the definition. What is meant by experiment? An experiment is defined as a process for which its result is well defined. Deterministic experiment is an experiment whose outcomes can be predicted with certain under ideal conditions. That means when we are doing an experiment, we can clearly say its end outcome. And a random experiment means whose all possible outcomes are known in advance, whose each outcome is not possible to predict in advance and can be repeated under ideal condition. The best example for a random experiment is rolling a die and a fair coin is tossed. The pictorial representation for an experiment. Experiment is classified into two categories, determinant experiment and random experiment. Determinant experiment example is genetic determination. For the random experiment, hitting the target. Next one is simple event. A simple event is the most basic possible outcomes of a random experiment and it cannot be decomposed further. What is meant by a random experiment? The random experiment means we cannot predict the end outcome. The obvious example is tossed a fair coin. That means we cannot predict whether tail is up here or head is up here when we are tossing. A sample space is the set of all the possible outcomes of a random experiment. Each point in a sample space is an elementary event. We shall look at an example. If a die is rolled, then the sample space, this is a simple example which was appeared in your lower classes. The sample space is for a single die 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly, for a coin is tossed, then the sample space is S, H, T. The sample space means the whole thing. The simple event means the part of it. That means 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 5, 6 are simple events. The whole thing is called its sample space. Mutually exclusive and inclusive events. Two events cannot occur simultaneously or mutually exclusive events. That means when we are taking the intersection of two simple events, the intersection is empty, then we can call this as mutually exclusive or disjoint events. Mutually inclusive means when we are taking the intersection between two events, the intersection is non-empty. We shall look at an example. Then, when we roll a die, the sample space S is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is already we know that. When we are considered the set 1, 3, intersection with 2, 4, 5, 6, 1, 3, this set is a simple event. Similarly, the set 2, 4, 5, 6 is another set. When we are taking the intersection, then we get an empty sets. The events 1, 3 and 2, 5, 6 are mutually exclusive events. But when we are considering the event of first set, let us call the set A as 2, 2, 3, 5, and the another set 5, 6 is as a B. Then we are taking the intersection means the common element is 5, so the intersection is non-empty. In this case, it was called mutually inclusive events. Venn diagram for our understanding. Let S is a whole sample space, A be a simple event, B be a simple event. When we are, these are disjoint, so we are calling mutually exclusive. Suppose the mutually inclusive means there should exist a common, at least one common element between these two. These are some examples of random experiment and their total outcomes and their sample spaces. These are all appeared in your lower classes. Tossing a fair coin, that means the total number of outcome is 2 to the power 1. 2, the sample space is h comma t. Suppose when we are tossing 2 coins, the total number of outcome is 2 square equal to 4. Sample space h comma h, h comma t, t comma h, t comma t. Similarly, when we are tossing the 3 coins, the outcome is 2 to the power 3 equal to 8. The sample space is, already we know that. Consider another example. When we are rolling a fair die, 6 to the power 1, 6. The sample space is, already we seen then, start from 1 and end with 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Suppose when we are rolling 2 dice, the total number of outcome is 6 to the power 2. 6 square, 36 elements, 1, 1, 2, and all the remaining things are known. This will be, this example we consider often when we are dealing with problems. And another example in the random experiment is drawing a card from a pack of 52 cards, 52 power 1. There are 4 category in the cards. First one is heart, second one is diamond, third one is pair, and fourth one is club. In the each category, there are 13 cards are appeared. In the first case, heart and diamond are red color and spade and club are black color. Heart, ace, then joker, queen and king are appeared. This is pictorial representation. When we are start with the random experiment, then end with the sample space S. For each sample space, we have collection of subsets. For each element of a subset, we can assign a value, that is probability value. The probability value, how we calculate for a sample space, we shall see in the next slide. I shall repeat once again. For each random experiment, there is a sample space. For each sample space, there are collection of subsets. For each collection of subsets, we assign the probability value. How we calculate the probability value for a given event? The probability of an event, let S be the sample space associated with the random experiment and A be an event. Let N of S and N of A be the number of elements of S and A respectively. That means that total number of elements in the sample space and the total number of elements in the simple event. Suppose if you want to find the probability of a simple event, we can divide the total number of elements in the simple event divided by the total number of elements in the sample space, then we get the probability of A. Already you know that probability of an event is lies between the value of 0 to 1. We shall see one example for this. 3 coins are tossed simultaneously. What is the probability of getting exactly one head, at least one head, and at most one head. Notice that three coins are tossed simultaneously, which is equivalent to one coin is tossed three times. This is more important when we are dealing the problems. This point is more important. That means three coins are tossed simultaneously is equal to the one coin is tossed three times. A sample space S, when we are taking the cross product, we get the eight elements. We already seen that the sample space for when we are tossing a single coin three times, the output is three times head can appear, two times head and one time tail, and so on. Let A be the event of getting one head, and B be the event of getting at least one head, and C be the event of getting at most one head. The first one is a simple case. Let A be the event of getting one head. We can collect the only one single head is appear. Total number of three elements is occurred. Then number of elements in A for the simple event A is three. Similarly for B, but it should be at least one head. That means our lower bound is there should exist at least one head and two or three heads also can occur in this event. So our sample space is H T comma T. Here is one head, T H comma T, T T H, H H. Here the two heads can appear because our condition is at least one head. Our lower bound is at least one head, and T H comma H, and three times H can occur. No other cases cannot occur in this event. So the total number of elements for the event B is 7. And the next one is at most one head. In probability theory, these two words are more important. At least one head and at most one head. At most means it is an upper bound. That in our event, only one head can occur or zero head also can occur. Here, first even, there is no head. Second one is one head, H, T, T. Then another is T, H, T, H, T. Then another one is T, T, H. So the number of elements is 4. Now we calculate the probabilities for the events of A, B, and C. So the probability of A means n of A by n of S, which is 3 by 8. Then the probability of B is 7 by 8. Then the probability of C is 1 by 2. Similarly, we can consider another example. When we are in a pair die is rolled in, what are the probability of getting the sum 7, 7 or 9, 7 or 12? The sample space is already we seen that first our let A be the event of getting sum is 7. We collect all the elements are whose sum is 7. The elements are 1, 6, 2, 5, 3, 4, 4, 3, 5, 2, 6, 1. So the total number of elements for the event A is 6. For the event B is, the event of getting the sum is 9. The elements are 3, 6, 4, 5, 5, 4, 6, 3. NB equal to 4. And finally, let C be the event of getting sum is 12. 6, 6, and C equal to 1. Our first problem is the probability of getting the sum is 7. This is simple one. Then N of A equal to N of S. The total number of elements for the event A is 6 divided by N of A divided by N of S, 6 divided by 36, 1 by 6. Then another one is probability of getting sum 7 or 9. Probability of A or B, that can be written as probability of A union B equal to probability of A plus probability of B. Here the intersection is empty because when we are tossing a 2 die, either 7 can appear or 9 can occur. Both cannot occur simultaneously. So these two events are disjoint events. So here we consider only probability of A or probability of B. In the probability problems, when R is equal, we can use the union symbol A union B. The probability of A union B means probability of A plus probability of B. Later on, we shall see the probability of A union B equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. But here our A intersection B is empty. Probability of empty is 0. So we consider only probability of A plus probability of B. In the next lecture, we shall see the basic theorems in probability theory. So now we are calculating N of A plus N of S plus N of B divided by N of S. 6 divided by 36 plus 4 divided by 36. When we are simplifying this, we get 5 divided by 12. Similarly, we can calculate the 7 or 12 values. So, thank you for your listening.